Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to fill a moon design nail. Now, we did this nail about 3 weeks ago and people have asked, well, how do you fill something like that? So I'm going to show you how. So here's the gorgeous nail. So we put some one stroke on it as well. Just still all intact, looking beautiful, I must say myself. So first of all, what I need to do is remove the little stones that we've put on. So I'm going to use some old cuticle nippers and just crack the gel from around the sides. Don't attempt to file those off because you'll just ruin your file. We don't want that. I'm going to push back the cuticle, which will obviously reveal more of the natural nail. So we're just doing that with the other end of the pinching tool. So your pinching tool is a two-way tool. So you've got your pincher on one end and your cuticle pusher on the other end. You've also got a little cuticle knife as well to scrape around if you need to scrape off any non-living tissue. And what we're going to do is I'm going to take away the artwork. I'm supporting the nail here. I'm going to file that off. And then what we're going to do is just buff in this fill line, make it nice and smooth. Don't file too much away here because you will start to lose the moon. Let's dust off that excess dust. So the colour that we used was Midnight Stardust. Just going to wipe over the nail with some acetone. And then we're going to dehydrate. So the prep procedure is the same as if you are doing a fill. And we're going to prime. I'm going to use high speed because it's only a small area. Plus I want it to set up quick so I can actually really make those edges sharp. There are two ways you can do this. You could build up your pink here, so the natural beige colour here and here, and then fill in with the blue. Or you could do the blue first, get that nice and neat, and then do the pink. That's the way we are going to do it. I think this is the easiest way to do it. So get your bead, take it to one side first, and the other side. Obviously, the more you have these nails on for, the further down the moon will grow till you get a full moon. So we had like a quarter of a moon, now we have a half moon. So just use your brush to keep that edge nice and neat. Make sure you match this point here. And then if you pat it, will also make it a little bit sharper. So it's kind of like when you do a smile line, but you're just doing it a lot further up the nail. Gonna get your warm beige. I'm Going to do one side at a time because you need to concentrate on what you're doing. So you button it right up to it, get it really neat at the cuticle. Bring it round. Feather it out. And do the same on the other side. And then you're going to make sure that the middles connect and add a bead there. So your structure is all rebalanced. Allow that to dry. And then what we will do, if you look at the side view of this, we're going to file till those two colours meet each other. And that's what's going to give you the sharp edge. So we're still not set properly. Because that's the hard nail that's set. Listen to the sound.
Will it take longer to set because there's not as much heat coming through? Because obviously you were going acrylic on acrylic as well, weren't you?
Yeah. If you look at this bit is set, but the coloured part hasn't set as much yet. Colour takes longer to set. Let's go for it. So now I'm going to go back into my normal filing routine, doing the side walls first. I'm going to angle my file because you don't want to over file this section. If you over file it, you'll lose the colour. Then you're going to file over the top. And can you see what's happening? The two colours are meeting and it gives it a crisp line. So you really got to be quite perfect when you do your filing, because if you just file willy-nilly, you will destroy the moon. You don't want to do that. We don't want a total eclipse.
Oh, what a bad pun.
I'm just refining the surface now. The surface of the moon. They get worse.
We don't want any craters.
No, we don't want any craters. That was a good one, Andrea. So using a white block, just going to smooth this nail. Did you see the fidget spinner going for it then? Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm filing it at the same time. Then we're going to wipe over with the pure acetone. And there you are. Can at that moon. Nice and crisp. I'm going to seal this with the Urban Graffiti top coat. I'm going to finish this nail off with some cuticle oil. I've got the freesia cuticle oil here. So don't be worried and thinking, oh, I don't want to do a moon design on somebody because I won't know how to fill it and I won't know how to maintain it. It's not that hard. That's how. For now. Can you remember that? That's how for now. I used to love that programme.
Yeah, I did too.
I think they should bring that back.
Terry Nutkins was like one of the guys in it.
I don't know.
Yeah, I just remember that name, Terry Nutkins.
They were just geeks, weren't they, really?
Yeah, just, that's why I am.
There you are. All restored and back to beauty. I hope you've enjoyed that video, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. All the products that I've used today will be listed below as always, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Keep watching. Bye-bye.
Well, I'll put it this way, it was minus 20 in the day.
In the day?
Right, my friend Joe, who's just
been...
In the day.
Yeah. My mate Joe, who's just been back over here, he's gone back to Minnesota today, right? Last week, minus 27 during the day.
Mm-hmm.
And that is normal.
That's normal. That's every day. That's
in Minnesota. Yeah. So that's in America.
Yeah. So Canada.
Further north.
Holy. Yeah. What's it give me at night?
Minus 40. Easy.
Oh my God. Yeah.